Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2326, the let function reusing a variable in a later variable. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen, my second episode here on let, and this one's far more complicated than the first one and shows off the power of this. My first episode yesterday, we're at the MVP summit, but because of coronavirus, everyone is doing it virtually. They announced that at like 11 o'clock, and I rushed to get a video out. But then this morning, I went looking for a better example, and I found this question from the Mr. Excel message board back in 2010, almost 10 years to the day. Mad Max N asked how to find the second to the last word in a phrase, and Special K99 came up with this formula. And thanks to Special K, 10 years later, for the basis of this solution. Right, so we have a bunch of phrases here to make life more difficult. There's spaces intermingled, right? So the first thing I have to do is get rid of the spaces, so the trim of A4, and this great function to figure out how many words we have. The length of B4 minus the length of, get rid of all the spaces in B4. And generally, you have to add one to this, but then I had an extra column here that said, all right, well, which word do I want? I want the answer from this minus 1. Which space do I want? I want the answer from that minus 1. So that all simplifies down to that simple thing. It's not really which word, it's which space. And then the awesome little trick here, I'm going to substitute in this phrase the space for a caret, but which space? Oh, I want the fifth one. And depending on how many words we have, it will be a different number each time. So what we're getting then is we're getting a caret right before the word that I want. All right, so I call that caroted text. And then from there, it's all fairly simple. Get the mid of this sub answer, find the caret plus 1, and just grab 30 characters, because how long can a word be? And then once we have those last two words in the phrase, that's simply find the space minus 1. All right, but you know, you can't, if someone sends this question in, you can't give them 5 formulas like this. So I go through a process of condensing these down to one formula, and I'm going to speed that up. We'll be right back. That was crazy, right? This formula is an insane formula, 370 characters. And what's happening is, you know, the sub answer in E4 was used twice, D4 is used 4 times, C4 is used 4 times, B4 is used 12 times, and so we're just repeating the same thing over and over and over again. And that's where the let function is going to solve this much better, right? So I come down to we have four variables essentially that are reused. And boy, I really should have called this trimmed phrase, but then the function becomes longer. So I created this little logic steps out here with the variables I'm going to use. Yes, Jordan Goldmeyer, look at me declaring variables here in the Excel grid instead of VBA. Maybe I've reformed. So T is equal to the trim of A4. Which word is the length of T? Beautiful, look, I get to reuse that. Minus the length of the substitute of T, where we get rid of the space. So that's counting which space. And then the substitute function of T, changing a space to a caret, which one? The WW one. And then finding everything after the caret, so the mid of the caroted text, find a colon and caroted text, plus 1, comma 30, and then the last one that's kind of just easy here. All right, let's walk through building of the let function, the syntax of let. We start with a variable name, comma definition. Variable name, comma definition, variable name, and there can be as many of these as you want. After that last comma, the final thing doesn't have a variable name, it's just the final calculation, so this, all right? And I'm going to build this rather than retype everything. I have it all up there already. All right, so rather than retype all this, I'm going to use text join. Between each item, I want a comma. And we'll take pairs like this and then add a comma afterwards. Copy that down. The calculation is just going to be that value. Perfect. And then equal text join. Between each one of these, I want a character 10. This whole thing, this will build the formula as text. This will build the formula as text, all right? And then an awesome trick. I learned this in Cleveland at General Electric maybe 15 years ago. I have a formula there in K21. I want to bring the value of that formula down to K22. So Control Shift quotation mark. It's kind of like a ditto. Brings it down, and now I just press Enter, and that should allow that formula to calculate ladder. That's great. All right, so I have that working now. I will come back up here to our original data, paste, and then copy and paste. So airport's considered due. It looks like it's working. All right, look at that, 154 characters. Now, you know, here's the question. I really had to build this like mentally first, or here in the grid first, before I started building that let function, because otherwise I found that I was when I tried to just build the let function without building this first, it was super hard. And then I almost wonder, when I hand this off to a coworker, you know, with just the original thing and this, is this any easier to understand than, I guess it is. There really should be some best practices here as far as like using the Alt Enter to put each variable on a new line. You know, and the problem is that people don't realize that they have to expand the formula bar. They think that that's the formula. You know, and like using T instead of trim text, maybe I should have called it trim text, but I was trying to get it to be shorter. Oh, hey, let me interrupt. This is after the video. I went back and changed T to trim text and tried to make all these a little bit more readable. Not caring about formula like now, just trying to make it easier to understand. Yeah, this is probably better. Back to the video. I don't know, this is all pretty new. It'll be really interesting to see what people come up with and how this develops, this new let function. But it definitely, definitely is an interesting, interesting thing. All right, hey, if you like these tips, please subscribe and ring the bell. This book, Mr. Excel 2020, I decided I'm actually going to print some of these. And while we've been selling the PDF, I am going to, the printer says, hey, you got 16 extra pages, so I'm going to add the let function to this book. If you've already bought the PDF, or if you buy the PDF today, I will get you the updated PDF as we go. I want to thank the calc team on the Excel team in Redmond for this awesome new let function. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.